These lines are being crossed over the atmosphere.
Maybe he's just sleeping, and
he is not just sleeping. Why did you tell him it was okay to put all that garbage on his sandwich? You know he has a heart condition.
Had a heart condition. Besides, it tasted good. I didn't think it would kill him.
You had him drink like 5 Red Bulls this morning. What did you think was going to happen?
Look, that was in the past. Right now, we have to worry about losing our jobs. Do you realize what happens to shoulder people who end up getting that person killed? We're through. We'll never find work again.
Well, maybe that's what we deserve then. You for letting Bob here kill himself, and me for letting it happen. Oh, Bob, he had a date tonight, too. He was gonna clean up the apartment, make some food, and we ruined it. What are you doing?
Shut up. Your voice is annoying and distracting. Bim, bam, boom. Now he can go on his date, and we don't lose our jobs. Win-win, right? High five.
This is wrong. This is disgusting. You can't... Did you bring him back to life?
What? No, that's stupid. His soul's probably already been processed. Nah, I just reanimated his corpse. He's basically a puppet. If the boss comes, she'll see Bob walking and talking just fine. Ooh, ooh. And now we can eat whatever we want without consequence. I mean, it's not like he can die twice, right? Okay, maybe I gotta practice a little bit.
Double.
I mean, it's not like I've puppeted a body before.
Double.
I wonder if I'll be able to get the hang of moving his hips for after the date.
Double!
Oh my god, what is it? You're so annoying.
I can't let you do this. I have to tell the boss we killed Bob.
Wait, stop! I'll make him kill someone.
What?
Yeah. In the time it'll take you to get up there, I'll have Bob kill someone. And it'll be your fault.
My fault?
Well, I mean, if you stayed, then I wouldn't use Bob's body to kill someone. So it's up to you, goody-goody. You can go and tattletale while I'll get some poor, innocent soul killed. Probably an orphan or something. Or you can stay here and I don't kill any orphans.
You are a horrible person.
That's kind of my job. Where's that cologne we bought 2 years ago and never used?
Well, we can't keep this up. It's going to...
Oh, no. Oh, shit, it's the boss! Quick, give me some cologne! Oh, clear spray! Oh. My god, what are you doing?
Well, I have to get the smell out somehow. We don't have any cologne.
Okay? We got this. Hey, Bob! How's it going?
Quiet, Devil. Why are the two of you still here on Earth? You were supposed to report to me and give me a debrief on how your human died the instant he died.
What in the...
Die? What are you talking about? Bob's never been more alive.
Hey.
Bobby here's going on a date tonight.
Is he drunk or something? What's wrong with him?
Oh, well, you know how.
Jill, don't touch me.
Sorry. But yeah, Bob's just a party
animal. How is it that I got a form then?
Oh, hold on. I got it here with me. Yep. Got a form here from processing. Says they received a Bob card, so he went through judgment and was sent to hell.
Oh, Bob! I'm so sorry. I should have done a better job. I should have made you donate to charity more.
Angel here's just whining about how we, Bob here became a cultist and sold his soul to Satan. That's why his soul got processed. He's still alive, just no soul.
That's strange. They didn't attach a Satanist addendum to the form. Says here he died of a heart attack?
Man, that is strange. Isn't that strange, Angel? Well, you know how those guys are. I mean, they process like a bajillion souls a day, right? Anyway, we gotta make sure Bob here is mentally prepared for his date, so...
See you later, boss.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna go talk to processing and see what the mix-up was about. Word of advice, though. Don't use cleaning spray as cologne. That's disgusting.
Will do!
Wait.
That was a close one. Oh my god.
Devil, we can't keep this up. She's gonna find out the truth and then we'll be in even more
It'll
trouble.
It'll be fine, Angel. With all the things she has to do, you really think this is gonna be high on her priority list? Plus, if Bob's in hell, it's not like she's gonna be able to go find Bob, ask him what happened. You realize how many people are in hell? A lot.
I wish you would just catch us. I mean, we're about to set up some nice girl on a date with a court.
She's not that nice. I mean, we... Is this a sitcom? I think that's her.
Okay, Devil, just open the door and tell her that the date's off. Don't do this to her, please.
Hey
Jennifer. Good to see ya.
Hey, Bob. I've been looking forward to this since we met at the bar.
The bar? Wait, Devil. Is this that one girl who you said was really desperate?
Oh, yeah. Jenny here has been single her entire life. Her parents died not too long ago, so she had to move out, find an apartment she could barely afford to live in. She works a job where everyone hates each other, and her. And her best friend that she's had since high school died in a car accident. She's perfect for Bob! No standards!
Devil, there comes a point where even you have to realize how wrong this is, right?
I think you're missing the point of a shoulder devil here. And besides, oh, look how happy she is. Someone's actually paying attention to her.
Bob, really?
I just got done getting the place as clean as I can for our date. Here, try some salsa. I asked my grandma for her recipe.
That literally canned salsa Bob bought at the dollar store a month ago.
Oh, really?
Angel, come on! Well, just what do you think I'm gonna do?
Okay.
Stop it! Oh. No. He's mine! Oh my god, stop it!
You never listen to me!
You're stupid, that's why!
You're always wrong!
No, I'm not! You're
ugly!
What? Look, look! Oh, I know, I know!
No, no, that was too far, even for you.
Look, we made a night, right?
No, the fact that you're trying to justify something like this means you know how wrong it is.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Can we go tell the boss now, please?
Yeah, yeah, let's go.
Bob killed was bad enough, but this is getting out of control. control.
It'll be fine, all right?
You were just agreeing with me that we should go tell the boss what happened.
I changed my mind. I was just in a state of shock after using Bob's body like that, but I got over it.
How do you get over something like that? You literally puppeteered a corpse.
Thanks for the synopsis. Now look, what's the worst that could happen at this point?
Yes. He couldn't have been dead then. That doesn't make any sense.
What do we do?
I don't know.
What do you mean?
What do you mean? What do I mean? What do we do about Jennifer?
What about her?
What the hell do you think I'm talking about?
I don't know what you're trying to get at here, but I do not appreciate you raising your voice at me. It's very rude.
Devil!
Look, we can't do anything, okay? We can't just screw with his body again or we'd really get in trouble.
We are already in trouble, you jackass. At least now we can try to get her out of trouble.
Angel, stop it!
Don't get off me, we have to split!
Just happened at the time that you left and you were here.
I have to go all the way to hell looking for your person's soul.
I told you she'd find out.
Now the big man was very sure that Bob died of a heart attack. And I know that he's never wrong, but I thought you two, or at least you, would have lied to my face. But no. Turns out Bob died of a heart attack because of your combined incompetence. And then you had the gall to throw his dead body around and
I wanted to report that it was our fault that Bob got killed, but double your threat to kill someone if I did.
Thanks. Yeah, real cool. Way to throw me under the bus. You're not so innocent yourself.
Me?
Yes, you.
How long do you think it takes me to get over here to take care of things? Do you think Devil could have killed someone in that time? Do you really think she would? That would get her into more trouble. And it's your job to come to me about this stuff. And you can't tell me that you weren't able to stop her while she was using Bob's body.
Did you even try to stop Devil?
Huh?
Well, I couldn't physically stop her, but...
But nothing!
You're in trouble. Well, I'll be on my way, so...
And in the end, the two of you are creepy and disgusting, but most of all, you are stupid! Now, I really want to know if you thought that you were going to get away with this. Seriously, I honestly want to know.
No. Yeah, maybe.
You're fired! Fired, both of you! Now, I say report to the big man for punishment, but I guess I have to escort you like a pair of preschoolers trying to eat glue and crayons.
Bob was like 4 years old, and it seemed like a good idea at the time.
What?
What?
Just shut up!